restaurant, and it's about Alice and the restaurant. But Alice's restaurant is not the name of the restaurant, it's just the name of the song. And that's why I call this song Alice's Restaurant. Destruction and headed down towards the city dump. But when we got there, there was a big sign with a chain on the cross dump saying it was closed on Thanksgiving. And we had never heard of a dump that was closed on Thanksgiving before. With tears in our eyes, we drove off in the sunset looking for another place to put the garbage. But we didn't find one. Until we came to the side road, and off the side of the side road, there was another 15 foot. Another pile of garbage, and we decided that one big pile of garbage was bigger than two little piles, so rather than bringing that one up, we decided to throw ours down. And that's what we did. Drove back to the church, had a Thanksgiving dinner that couldn't be beat, went to sleep and didn't wake up until the next morning when we got a phone call from Officer Obey. He said, "Kid, well, we found your name at the envelope at the bottom of a half ton of garbage. About it." And I said, "Yes, sir, Officer Obey, I cannot tell a lie." Well, I put that envelope under the garbage. Well, after speaking to Obey for about 45 minutes on the telephone, we finally arrived to the truth of the matter. Was that we had to go down and pick up the garbage, and we also had to go down and speak to him at the police officer station. So we got in the red VW microbus with the shovels and the rakes and the implements of destruction, and we headed out towards the police officer station. Now, friends, there was one of two things that we could have done at the police station. And the first, he could have given us a medal for being so brave and honest on the telephone, which wasn't very likely, and we weren't expecting that. The other thing was that he could have bawled us out, told us never to be seen driving garbage around in that vicinity again, which is kind of what we expected. And we was both immediately arrested, handcuffed. And I said, "Obie, well, I don't think I can pick up the garbage with these handcuffs on." And he said, "Shut up, kid. Get that in the back of the patrol car." And that's what we did. Sat in the back of the patrol car and drove to the quote-unquote scene of the crime. And now I want to tell you about this town of Stockbridge, Massachusetts. It's where it all happened. You know, they got three stop signs, two police cars, one police car, but when we got to the scene of the crime, there was five police officers, three police cars, being the biggest crime in the last 50 years, and everybody wanted to get up into the newspaper's story about it. They was using all kinds of equipment hanging around the police officer station. They was taking plastic tiger tracks, footprints, dog smelling prints, and they took 27 8x10 color glossy photographs with circles and arrows and paragraphs on the back of each one explaining what each one was to use as evidence against us. to mention the aerophotography. Well, after the ordeal, we went back to jail, and Obi said he was going to put us in the cell. He said, hey, kid, I'm going to put you in the cell. I want your wallet, and I want your belt. And I said, Obi, I understand you want my wallet, since I don't have any money to spend in the cell. But what do you want my belt for? And he said, kid, we don't want any hands. I said, Obi, do you really think I'm gonna hang myself for literally? Well, Obi just said he was making sure, and friends only was, because he happened to take the toilet seat off the toilet so I couldn't hit myself in the head and drown. He also took the toilet paper out of the cell so I couldn't bend the bars apart. Escape. Well, Obi said he was just making sure, and it was about 4 or 5 hours, and then Alice. Remember Alice? Yeah, this is a song about Alice. Well, Alice came by with a few nasty words for Obi on the side, and he bailed us out of jail. We went back to church, had another Thanksgiving dinner that couldn't be beat. Till the next morning, till we all had to go to court. Yeah! Well, we walked in and we sat down. Obi came in with the 27 8x10 color glossy pictures with the circles and arrows and the paragraphs on the back of each one, and he sat down. Man came in, told us all to rise, and we stood up. Obi stood up with the 27 8x10 color glossy pictures. With a see and die dog, and he sat down, we sat down. Obi looked at the see and eye dog, and then he looked back at the 27 8x10 color glossy pictures with the circles and the arrows and the paragraphs on the back each one, and then he looked back at the see and eye dog, and then at the 27 8x10 color glossy pictures with the arrows and the paragraphs on the back of each one, and he began to cry. And the judge was never going to look at those 8x10, 27 8x10 color glossy photographs with the arrows and the pictures and the, you know, paragraph on the back of each one, using it as evidence against us. And we was fined $50 and to pick up the garbage in the snow. But that ain't what I came to tell you about. I came to talk about the draft. Well, they got a building down in New York City called Whitehall Street. And when you walk in, you get injected, inspected, detected, infected, neglected, and selected. But when I went down to get my physical examination that day, I walked in, I sat down, and I got good and drunk the night before. So I could look and feel my best when I came in there that morning. Cause I wanted to look like an all-American kid from New York City. I wanted to feel like I wanted to be an all-American kid from New York City. And I walked in and I sat down, I was hung down, hung up, and all kinds of mean, nasty things. And I walked in and he sat down and gave me a piece of paper and said, kid, go down and see that psychiatrist in room 604. And I went up there. And I said, shrink, I want to kill. I mean, I want to kill. I want to see blood and gore and guts and veins hanging out of my teeth, eat burnt dead bodies. I mean, kill. And he started jumping up and down with me, and we were all jumping up too good about that. Proceeded on down the hall, getting more injection, inspection, detection, deflections, all kinds of stuff they was doing to me. After the whole thing being there, I walked up and said, well, what do you want? And he said, kid, we got only one question for you. Well, have you ever been arrested?